The old proverb goes, incest is best, so put your brother to the test. I can't even. We have a barf bag offset just in case. Hey everyone, Laci Green here. It's everyone's favorite subject, incest. No, really, it seriously feels like incest is now everyone's favorite topic. It's a big Japanese porn thing, it's a big Game of Thrones thing, a big Yahoo Answers thing, apparently. Humans. Incest is a moral dilemma as well as a scientific one. Few things provoke such disgust for most people as the idea of having sex with a blood relative. Of course, non-consensual sexual contact with a family member is a form of abuse and absolutely not okay, but what about when it's consensual and they're not having kids? It's hard for a rational person to reason out of, and yet the disgust is still going strong. But this is science time because yay D-news, so let's talk about incest or inbreeding from a scientific standpoint. A recent report in the open access journal PureJ found that inbreeding and woolly mammoths from the North Sea may be why they went extinct. The researchers' main clue was cervical ribs on the neck of the fossils. These ribs are known to develop when genetic or environmental disturbances take place while the embryo is developing. There are also other birth defects that are associated with this mutation, and the scientists believe those abnormalities could have played a role in the mammoth's ability to survive. Now, mammoths aren't the only species speculated to have inbred. In fact, most species will inbreed if it's the only option. Other animals known to inbreed often are house cats. Bonobos practice incest as part of social bonding, and in some species of wasp, over 90% of them mate with their brother or sister. It's a strange paradox given the hell that inbreeding can wreck on the offspring. Inbreeding basically means that there's no diversity of the genetic pool, so bad genes are magnified. With outbreeding? Is that a word? Basically, how it goes down is that when humans breed with non-relatives, the offspring gets two copies of a particular gene. So if one copy isn't good, they have a normal one as backup. Inbreeding, particularly over many generations, completely eliminates these backups across hundreds or thousands of genes, which can cause some weird mutations and exaggerations of genetic effects. It'll also cause fertility issues eventually. Now, even though there are several species, including humans, that practice incest and inbreeding, the majority of the animal kingdom rejects incestuous advances in normal circumstances. It's thought that different species have evolved different mechanisms to make sure that they don't put their genes at risk. For humans, that mechanism may be a combination of psychological systems, including the scent of their pheromones and facial detection. Now, I know that incest is kind of gross, but when you think about that disgust as a possible evolutionary response, it's actually kind of interesting. Let me know what you think about it down below, and I'll catch you next time with more D News updates.